Praise the Lord! Wretched Knucklehead here, a.k.a. Brother Billy Jr. Brothers and sisters, we turn our Bibles to 1 John chapter 1. We'll be looking at verses 1 to 4. And it reads, that which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked upon, and our hands have handled, of the word of life. For the life was manifest, and we have seen it, and bear witness, and show unto you the eternal life, which was with the Father, and was manifested unto us. That which we have seen and heard, declare we unto you, that ye also may have fellowship with us. And truly our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. And these things write we unto you, that your joy may be full. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, to the hearing, to the admission, to the application, to the distribution of this great word, taken from the greatest book that man could ever possess. And my brother, this is God's word. We give God all the honor, all the glory, all the praise in the precious name of his Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord, amen. I gotta back up. Praise the Lord. I gotta back up. Praise the Lord. I'm backing up. Praise the Lord. Brothers and sisters, in 1 John chapter 1, we see the Apostle John opening up to the readers. He has an objective of why he's writing this beautiful letter, this great man of God, this preacher of the gospel of grace, where he tells the readers how he's seen, how he's heard, how he's valued the things of God, the things through his Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. He's seen it, he's heard it, he's witnessed it. Has seen it with his eyes, heard it with his ears, witnessed it, and put such value on it. Where he brings up to open up this beautiful letter, 1 John, in the first chapter, explaining this, and the objective goal is to show that through this fellowship that he had amongst other grace believers. Believers of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Believers of the gospel. Believers of once saved, always saved. He even mentions it. Through which we have eternal life. And his fellowship. He says this amongst the other brethren. And he's sharing with these brethren. That we have this fellowship. Knowing about God's love. Knowing about God's mercy. Knowing about God's forgiveness of all our sins. Past, present, and future. And this agape love, this love that's not based on what we've done, but based on who God is. And he goes on to say, this is the fellowship that we have. And this fellowship, this true fellowship, is with our Abba Father and with his Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Where he also goes on to say, where he ends off in the fourth verse, he says that when you know this, that your joy may be full. He is echoing the same words our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ said to the disciples in the upper room when he's sharing this tender moment with the disciples. Where he says in John chapter 15, verse 11, I have spoken these things to you that my joy may remain in you and that your joy would be filled. And how's your joy filled? When you have fellowship with the gospel of grace, when you have fellowship with Jesus Christ, when you have fellowship with Abba Father who loves you so much. Jesus goes on to say in that same upper room, that tender moment that he's having with his disciples just before he's going to go to the cross. He says this in John chapter 16, verse 24. He says, heareth all, you have not asked nothing in my name. But if you ask, you shall receive, and your joy, praise the Lord, will be full. And so when you fellowship with God and know about his love and know much how much he loves you, he don't wanna dominate you. He don't wanna go upside your head when you make mistakes. No! He wants to love you. He wants to forgive you of all your sins, past, present, and future. He wants to give you mercy. He wants to give you grace. He wants to bless you. And when you do that, that is the objective reason of why the Apostle John is writing these letters. It is specific, but in general, that's what the Bible is all about. So have fellowship with the believers in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Have fellowship with our Abba Father, and have fellowship with his Son, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And God will be glorified, you will be edified, and the kingdom of darkness, praise the Lord, will be nullified. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you. May the Lord lift up his countenance to you. May the Lord give you his peace. And I commend you all to God and to the word of his grace, which is able to build you up an inheritance to those who are sanctified in the precious name of his Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, amen. And now to him that is able to keep you from falling, present you faultless in the presence of his glory, both glory, majesty, dominion, power, both now and forevermore. Praise the Lord, amen. I had to go to Starbucks and get me some refreshments. I'm going to enjoy it. And the joy of the Lord is our strength. God bless you. Agape love. Praise the Lord.